In its desire to save the Yoruba language from going into extinction, the Lagos State House of Assembly has called on Governor Akinwumi Ambode to direct the Ministry of Education to ensure that the teaching and speaking of Yoruba language are made compulsory across public and private schools in the state. The motion was moved during the House's Thursday Yoruba plenary by the Chairman House Committee on Education. The House, among other prayers, also wants a day set aside in the state in which the Yoruba language be celebrated across the states.
Lati pase fun commissioner to nboju to oro asa ise ona ati irin ajo afẹ lati ya ojo kan soto lodo odun gege bi ayaju ayeye asa ati ise ona ile yoruba lati polongo ilo ede yoruba gege bi ona ibara edi soro ati idunadura
won ti we won fi ara mo awon ti o fara mo lo po julo agba badan wole
agbe kale iwe ofin le Nigeria o so pe omo ti ababi to nlo le iwe o gbodo ko ede agbegbe ti o dagba si ni bayi le igbimo asofin ati se abadofin to so wi pe ede gbodo di kon pa ni kiko ni kika ati ni siso ni gbogbo awon ile iwe wa ni ipinle Eko yala ati ijoba ni o abi ti aladani to ba fi ma di gba die sisin ofin yen o ma bere si fese mule ni to je pe ni gbogbo ile iwe wa patapata agbodo ma ko ede yoruba ade gbodo ma so ade to ba so ede nu o so apoyako o de so orirun enu idi niyan ti ile igbimo asofin ipinle ko fi n gbegbe se lati ri pe ede yoruba ko parun o tun gberu si.
Welcome to the personality interview segment of Lagos Parliament, known as My Stewardship. On the program this week, you will be meeting the lawmaker representing Ifakọ Ajayi Constituency 1 in the Lagos State House of Assembly, who also happens to be the Chairman House Committee on the Environment, Honorable Dayo Saka Fafunmi. Welcome to the program, sir.
Thank you very much.
Yes, I'm sure viewers at home are already itching to meet you. Now let's start this way. As a trained electrical engineer, also a degree holder in law, why did you venture into politics and why the lawmaking business?
Engineering background, law, why am I into politics? Politics is about governance. The business of governance is a serious business that needs professionals. I'm one of the professionals in politics. And if you look at the history of politics in Nigeria, professionals in politics, they have done exceedingly well. Even the governor of Lagos State is a professional in politics, who find himself in politics, a chartered accountant. And even our leader, Bola Tinubu, is not just a politician, but is a professional in politics. So it is my desire to serve. Was born out of the conviction that I know I can make a difference in my level of representation.
All right, sir. Twice your constituents have entrusted you with their mandate, in the year 2007, 2011, and the current term. Now, what have you been able to do for them in return?
Good question. By the time I assumed office, I noticed a sharp decline in the quest for tertiary education. So the first thing I did was to say, look, you just have to go back to school. And I started giving free jam forms. As a politician, what is important is not the amount of wealth that you have, but the number of lives that you have touched collectively. So I started with that and ensured that I step up that the computer activity, because that's what is important. Over the years, I've trained to be modest, I'll tell you I've trained well over 5,000 since 2008, because I started since 2008. I didn't stop at that alone. I have a fashion institute where they learn art of tailoring and fashion designing. And you'll be surprised that it's 1 year program. It's not a political program.
And it's free.
It's free. 1 year, one calendar year. Aside all that, I also engage in provision of free bus ride for my constituents. I know how it is. I remember when I was in primary school that we had to trek to local authority Agege here because there was no school in Ifakoyai. And in the process, a lot of things happened on the road. I see that at this new generation, I should bridge the gap between the poor and the rich. Recently, the aim thing is people make a lot of money through makeup, facials, beauty treatment, and stuff like that. I decided to introduce it so that those young school leavers can earn living if you are sure on a weekly basis. There's no week that they're not going to make 10,000 to 15,000, because you see, the need of our people is to create economic activity. When you are able to fend for yourself,
they can actually be independent on their own.
They can be independent on their own, and that's the essence. You know, I believe in teaching people how to fish. If you are thinking, education means hope. Education means everything to me, because an educated mind is an ideal mind, is a living, is a mind that is alive. But when you are not informed, you know where you belong to.
All right, you were the chairman of the Committee on Works and Infrastructure, also on public accounts and local governments. Presently, you are the chairman of the Committee on the Environment. How has it been being the chairman of these committees, working with these committees?
Well, I'll say that you have diverse level of interaction, experience, achievements, challenges and prospects when you traverse, you know, amongst these three different committees. I would say that it's quite challenging. The opportunities, the challenges, I would say, are enormous. And
but then you've been able to manage them.
Oh, come on, I'm up to the task based on my background and everything.
All right, finally on this segment, before I let you go, I've got two questions for you. The first one is, what should Lagos residents expect from the Lagos State House of Assembly in coming years? And the other part of the question is, what should your own constituents expect from you in coming years?
I'll tell you that what we expect to see, or what will happen, will be programs that will meet the needs and expectations of the people in the coming year. And for me, I'll say that all my programs will continue, because I'm in tune with my people, and I'll continue to give them my best, as
best,
I promised them.
Say.
Yeah, I'll always continue to give them my best.
Yes, it's been nice chatting with you on the program, sir. Thank you so much for coming on the program. And I've been chatting with the lawmaker representing Ifakoyai Constituency 1 in the Lagos State House of Assembly, who also happens to be the Chairman House Committee on the Environment, Honorable Dayo Saka Fafunmi. Thank you so much for coming once again.
Thank you.
Yes, the program continues shortly. Please stay with us. While a visit to Ifakoyai Constituency 1 gave an insight into the contributions being made by the lawmaker representing the people in the legislative chamber.
To learn makeup outside is very expensive, and you know, some makeups they do collect 80k, 150. But he's free here, and he didn't collect any time from there. I just want to thank the Honorable Dayo Saka Fafunmi. He's been a father, he's been there for everyone. You know, to organize something like this is not easy.
So just put the logo at the center of the page. Well, this is about my second or third time of driving this bus. It's normal to me. It's just a way of allowing the youth to see their role model. That they should. I want to create a platform where the youth, or especially the young ones, will have access to me as a representative. And as you can see, it's just what I'm trying to do is just to make them know that where I am is just a stone throw from them. They can as well aspire and get to where I am. Bye bye. I should come tomorrow. Okay, I'll come tomorrow. This bus has a capacity, the seating capacity of over 80. You understand? Seating capacity of over 80 students. Depends on the traffic in the morning, and it's just a way to reduce the suffering of the people. Because most of them, at least, their parents will be able to save more money and do other things. It's essentially, I'm doing it for me to bridge the gap between the rich and the poor. This is one of the programs that remains in the heart of many. The two buses will convey well over 200 students at once. And what it does is, they stop at every junction, every school, drop the students. After dropping the students, then they pick another student.
I am happy because Saka bought this bus for us. I'm telling Saka thank you very much for giving us a new school bus. And it's also driving us home.
Wow! Thank you.
Saka is a good man. Oh.
Saka, we love you. God will provide for you.
Saka is a good man.
The program is still Lagos Parliament, but just before we go, here are some legislative tidbits. Now, do you know that the Lagos State House of Assembly is made of four women as members? Honorable Adefunle Otejo-Osho, lawmaker representing Mushi Constituency 1. Honorable Omotayo Oduntan, lawmaker representing Alimosho Constituency 2. Honorable Musumola Shogodara, lawmaker representing Surulere Constituency 2. And Honorable Mojisola Miranda, lawmaker representing Apapa Constituency 1. But that's it on the program this week. Thanks for watching. I am Abimbola Agbebi. Join us again next week. Bye for now.